Okay, here are the little bits of the base of the Scale 75. A little notch there, a little locating pin thing. That's how it goes together. Oops, approximately. Possibly do with a clean. I was going to use epoxy resin on it, but I don't think I need to. I think that's where that goes. I'll have to glue it. It's meant to be ruins anyway, so I suppose it doesn't really matter if it doesn't look perfect. Okay, so I'm going to glue that together now. Okay, I put some of this super glue on it. Ram it into position. I let that dry for a while, then I'll come back and see if I can work out what's the best place for that to go. I wonder if one of my little horses would fit on there. Well, we'll see. Okay, back in a minute. Okay, well, this is these two parts have been glued. And I'm gonna just tidy them up with this earth texture. Sort of a thick paste. So I'm going to let's just smooth that over. Well, this is the back of it. Nobody's really gonna see too much of this anyway, but let's tidy it up in any case. Right, that's that. And then where we did a bit of cutting on it, put a bit of this up there. Because this is acrylic, it's water soluble, or you can too much. Can use water to make it more amenable to whatever it is you want to do with it. Let's just see. You can try and get that on the camera. This is the sort of stuff you would normally use for like base in war games figures or that kind of thing. But it does a good job. It looks fairly realistic. By the way, I'm wearing a mask because somebody in the house has COVID and I don't want to catch it. left off that other little piece, that broken column or whatever it is, because it'd be a bit difficult to get in behind it. This looks like, I suppose, a bit of wind-blown sand has gathered up. At least that's what I hope what it looks like. Let's push that right in there. You can, how well you can see that. It's a very good little sculpt, a nice little base, but I'm not sure that in reality these hieroglyphs would go all the way to the bottom of the figure. I'll just put a bit more rough stuff under there, and maybe a little gap there. Look, if you can see that. Make it look like sand has blown in some in there and gathered up. Let's see. Looks about right, I think. Could add a bit more of this later on. Where's that other bit? So that's going to lie across there. Maybe make it look a bit rougher. I don't like to leave the lid off there for too long. Tries pretty hard, this stuff. It's quite a good finish to it. Then once I've primed this, I can always use some more of that if I need to. So that's just that little part of it. Okay, so we'll pause there. Go and wash my tools and stuff. See you next time. Okay, at this point, what I'm going to do is just open up my new airbrush, still in the shrink wrap. It's this Harder and Steenbeck Infinity CR Plus. Got an Iwata Neo. It works, but it's not working very well at the moment. Maybe it needs some sort of service or something. That's that. I'll just give you a quick look around the box. It's not too much on it. Let me just move this camera back a bit. That's it. The two little clips. Is that what opens it? No. It's not going to plan. As you mean to go on. Well, there's the instruction book. Got that out. What's going on here then? Oh, okay. Push one way and one the other way. Alright, that's just a bit of packing. And here's our airbrush. It does look beautiful, I will say. Got a quick release mechanism. I don't have the matching part for that. There's a little needle protector, I believe, that just... Oh, I thought that just stuck on there. And this is some sort of little tool. I'll find out about all those things later, I'm sure. So, new airbrush. I'll give it a go in a minute. Okay, well, I've got my new airbrush here. Put a little bit of paint in it from the start on this, but I notice it's leaking air. Can you hear that? Not sure what that's about. Let's see if it's looks okay, it seems to be spraying reasonably. What I'm doing here, I'm doing the darker recess. Maybe I've got the pressure turned up too high. Just about out of paint. Put a little bit more in. I'm using, for these shadows, I'm using the model air German Grey. A few drops of that. I'm going to have to read the instructions for this airbrush because I'm sure it's not meant to be hissing like that. I got through the paint quickly anyway. Alright. I think it's time to turn the pressure down. Okay, I'm just spraying up a bit of this lighter shade. I'll show you in a minute which one that is. This one, light bright brown, and then for some highlights I was going to use this one. I'm getting used to this airbrush. I don't have too much paint. Still putting out a little bit too much paint, so maybe I've got to reduce the pressure or something. One thing's for sure, this airbrush is very definitely different to the Iwata Neo that I was using. I cannot let that dry, so. Back in a minute. Okay, back again. This airbrushing that I've done so far has dried up. This is the little piece that's to go on the base. We're going to use a little bit of this model air khaki brown. I think it's Japanese khaki brown. Just to to dirty up some of the parts of the base. Also, I'm experimenting with the airbrush. Hopefully you can see that okay. Let me just adjust these lights. Okay. That's that. And let's take this. This airbrush still seems to be giving out a lot more paint than I would expect it to. That's a better look. As I'm doing this, I notice there's fine lines on here, like this has been 3D printed. The base, that is, not the airbrush. I don't know if you can see those, but from where I'm sitting there, noticeable. I sort of missed that one. Very different airbrush to the Iwata Neo that I've previously been using. As you can see, what I'm sort of doing here, trying to do, is getting in the under overhangs. Just so that it looks. So you can really see there. I hope you can see there. All these fine lines look almost like a fingerprint. It's a bit stark looking, isn't it? Let's put a bit of this light grey. See if we can reduce that a bit. Try it on this piece here first. Can you see that okay? Looks alright in my hand, but on the camera it looks very dark. Okay, that seems to be reasonable. Okay, well, I just adjusted the airbrush a little and the compressor. Get a little more. Still not quite right, that's too much paint coming out, so let's try this. Thank you. That's definitely better than it was. But it still needs a bit more adjustment. Just this now.